Thanks for joining me again, folks. Today we're looking at four frequencies that are going to save your guitars. Now, this is a video about electric guitars, rhythm guitars, mostly. There is going to be another video about acoustic guitars because they're a totally separate beast. Let's jump right in and we'll get going. Okay, so the first magic frequency is going to be 1K. This is going to help to bring the guitars out, pop them out the speakers, and make them sound more forward, more present. Here is the guitars without, and then we'll introduce the boost. Here, that just kind of filled out a little bit. Let me pop that into solo for you and you can hear what that's doing. Similarly, if we cut 1K, you'll hear the guitars almost disappear. Cool. Moving on. Okay, so your next magic frequency to boost is going to be around about 2.5K. Let's have a listen to that. That's going to give you a little bit of brightness, a little bit of aggressiveness, just kind of pull out some of the character of the guitars. So let's play again and then I'll introduce that boost. Again, as you can hear, as I roll this back, the guitars sound weedy and thin, and you push it in, and in solo, it kind of sounds a little bit like ass. You have this sort of yin-yang frequency going on. But in the context of the mix, a lot of that gets lost, and it just gives the guitars a bit of a presence lift. All right, let's move on. All right, so the next frequency we want to do for sort of top-end definition clarity will be a shelf around 5K. See, now I've rebalanced the output volume because obviously when you're EQing something, you're adding, or if you boost an EQ, you're adding energy to it, so you're going to be adding volume. So it's always good practice to kind of just balance the output a little bit as well to make sure that you're not being deceived by louder is better. So once we balance that and I bypass that and AB, the guitars just have so much more clarity in them now. Let's just A/B again real quick. Now, if you want a really present, like a really airy top boost, you can actually boost more around 8K. Let's hear what that sounds like. We'll be right back. can get away with boosting a lot more 8K in these particular guitars than I can 5K, but I think I prefer the sound of the 5 boost, because remember, it is a shelf, so therefore 8 will be getting boosted as well in a shelf manner. Okay, the next frequency you want to be addressing, shall we say, is at around about 4K, 3 to 4.5K, maybe somewhere in that region. Now, I am running out of bands on this SSL. So let's have a look at a 560 on this, and it just so happens that the 560 has a 4K band. So let's pull that down a little bit and see how we sound. That just immediately sounds a lot better with 4K pulled out of it. As you can hear, this is again a type of yinging frequency that's happening in the upper mid. And you know, this rhythm guitar channel, I'm affecting the bus with all of them, but if you think about it, there is, you know, 6 pairs of guitars happening. I mean, the main rhythms are 2 pairs, so 4 guitars. Them types of frequencies tend to build up quite a lot. So just a small cut there, and what's that, 3 dB, makes a huge difference. Let's listen to that again. Now then, back to the SSL channel. The high pass filter, we want to cut that off at around about 120. Maybe 70, it depends if you're working with extended range guitars, you might want to drop that down a little bit because they're going to have a lot more lows in them that you're going to need. But for standard tuning, let's roll it up, see how we go. Can actually get away with going a little bit higher in these guitars, to be honest. If you're on headphones or monitors, listen very carefully to this low rumble when this is out, and listen to the point in which the low rumble disappears but the guitars keep the body. See, around here this is too much. We'll go around there, about 128. Let's see how that sounds in the context. So in the context of the mix, you're not hearing a huge difference here, but not all your EQ moves are about hearing a massive difference. It's more about the context of the bigger picture. Because as you can hear, when the guitars are soloed, there's a lot of low rumbling going on there. Now that's going to interact with your bass, kick drum, any other instrument that's got low end in it. It's just frequency that you don't need. And if you don't need it and you can't really hear it in the mix anyway, best to get rid of it. So that wraps up today's video about 4 magic frequencies that will save your guitars. I know we were listening to distorted rhythms today, but those same frequencies apply to clean guitars as well, to be honest. General electric guitars, to be honest. Those frequencies will certainly get you in the ballpark to make sure that you're sitting in a good spot. And as you can hear, you know, small changes make a big difference in the context of the mix. Always remember, when you're EQing, no one's going to hear these parts in solo. Always try to EQ in the context of the mix, because you'll be surprised that some boosts or cuts you can make to certain instruments, I mean, we're not just talking guitars here, this could be anything, sound like shit when they're in solo, but you put them in the mix and all of a sudden they come alive. But above all else, if I was to give you a piece of forum advice, it's use your ears, bro. Anyway, that's enough rambling for today. Thanks a lot for joining me again. I hope you found this video helpful. If you're finding my content helpful, informative, entertaining, whatever, please consider subscribing to the channel, because it would really help me, grow and all them YouTube begging things, you know, hit the bell for notifications. Listen, I'm not expecting you to hit the bell to be notified of every video I upload. If we did that on every channel we subscribe to, life would be a real mess. But do consider subscribing. I'm hoping that my content is entertaining and good enough for you to want to come back to my channel and not have to be reminded when I've put a new video up, so that's what I'm going with. Anyway, thanks for joining me, and I hope to see you again soon. Cheers.